In this video, we are going to learn about the working of Zener diode. We will see how it is made, how it works, and where it is used. Before we dive into Zener diodes, let's first recall what a diode is. A diode is a semiconductor device that allows current to flow in one direction only. It has two terminals, the anode and cathode. The anode is positive side and cathode is negative side. When a diode is connected in a such a way that the positive terminal of battery is connected to anode and negative terminal to the cathode, it is said to be forward biased. In this condition, the current flows through the diode. However, if you reverse the connection, making the battery's positive terminal connected to cathode and negative terminal connected to anode, the diode becomes reverse biased and ideally no current flows. But in the case of Zener diode, it allows current to flow not only in the forward direction like a normal diode but also in the reverse direction when a certain voltage is reached. This voltage is called the Zener voltage. Now we look at the construction of Zener diode. A Zener diode is made from a semiconductor material, usually silicon. The P-type materials and N-type materials in a Zener diode are heavily doped. This means more impurities are added to the material. This heavy doping makes the Zener diode different from the regular diode. Here P-N junction is the place where P-type material and N-type material are meet. In the Zener diode, this junction is very narrow due to the heavy doping. The Zener diode looks like a small electronic component with two legs, just like a regular diode. One leg is the anode, which is positive side, and the other is cathode, that is negative side. Usually, there is a band on the cathode side to help you connect it correctly in a circuit. Let's now understand how the Zener diode works. The Zener diode can operate in two different modes, forward bias and reverse bias. In the forward bias mode, the Zener diode behaves like a regular diode. When you connect the positive side of the battery to the anode and negative side to the cathode, the Zener diode works like a regular diode. It allows current to flow from anode to cathode. The unique behavior of Zener diode is observed when it is reverse biased. When the positive terminal of the power supply is connected to cathode and the negative terminal to the anode, the Zener diode initially blocks the current just like a regular diode. However, when the reverse voltage increases and reaches a specific value known as the Zener breakdown voltage or simply Zener voltage, the Zener diode starts to conduct current. This process is called as Zener effect. In a Zener diode, the breakdown is a phenomenon that occurs when a specific value of reverse voltage is reached. This allows the diode to conduct current in the reverse direction. In a Zener diode, there are two types of breakdown occurs. These are Zener breakdown and avalanche breakdown. Zener breakdown occurs at low reverse voltage, typically below 5 volt. This breakdown happens due to the Zener effect, which involves quantum mechanical tunneling. When the reverse voltage reaches the Zener breakdown voltage, the electric field across the P-N junction becomes so strong that it pulls electrons from the valence band to the conduction band. This allows the electrons to tunnel through the depletion region, causing a sudden flow of reverse current. Whereas the avalanche breakdown occurs at higher reverse voltages, typically above 5 volt. In avalanche breakdown, the reverse voltage creates a strong electric field, but instead of tunneling, it causes free electrons to gain lot of energy. These high energy electrons then collide with atoms in the semiconductor lattice, knocking off more electrons in a process called impact ionization. As more and more electrons get knocked loose, the current multiplies like an avalanche. It's typically seen in higher voltage circuits, often for protection. Here both the types of breakdowns allows the current to flow in reverse direction only when the voltage across it reaches the Zener voltage. This voltage is constant, meaning that even if the input voltage increases, the voltage across the Zener diode stays the same. This is why the Zener diodes are often used to stabilize or regulate the voltage in circuits. Now that we understand how the Zener diode works, now let's explore some of its application in real life. First is voltage regulation. Many electronic devices require a constant voltage to operate correctly. The Zener diode helps to maintain a stable voltage across the load. In voltage regulation circuit, a Zener diode is connected in reverse bias across the load with a resistor in series to limit the current. Second is overvoltage protection. Zener diodes are commonly used to protect sensitive electronic components from voltage spikes or voltage surge. In an overvoltage protection circuit, the Zener diode is connected in parallel with the component to be protected. When the voltage exceeds the Zener voltage, the diode conducts and limits the voltage, preventing it from rising further. Third is switching circuits. Zener diodes can also be used in switching circuits where they act as a voltage control switch. These circuits are used in applications that require automatic control based on voltage levels. In such circuit, the Zener diode is placed in reverse bias and monitors the voltage level. When the voltage reaches the Zener voltage, the diode conducts and triggers a switch to change states, either turning on or off another part of the circuits.